Hello there. Let's jump right into installing a Facebook pixel in WordPress in the year 2020. This should still be relevant 2021, and I will keep it updated. I am going to jump in right away. The first thing we want to do is search in Google Chrome for Facebook pixel helper. So you'll want to use Chrome, and the top result will let you install this as a Chrome extension. So if you're not sure if your Facebook page already has a pixel, you can just go to it. And with this extension, it'll pop up at the top. It'll tell you whether you have a pixel, but also we're gonna need to use this tool at the very end because it is going to tell us if the pixel is installed properly. So that was the very first thing. Now we can jump into Facebook business settings. So if you want a tutorial on setting up Facebook Business Manager, I'm happy to do that. So there's a few places you can get to Facebook Business Manager. You can just search for it and you'll either log in, or if you're already logged into your account, you can actually select your page. If you're just on your main Facebook page, this is the updated thing. It may look different for you. Normally it's in the top corner. You can select Business Manager, but since they've updated it, you can actually go to Ads Manager, and that will take you to the whole business settings thing. So you can go from Ads Manager to Business Settings. And yeah, you can see we're at the same place, so you can Google it. You can also access it through Facebook. So I'm going to go to my actual business. If you just have one, that should be the default, and that'll take me to business settings. Now what we want to go to is data sources, because this is where the pixel lives. So you can't actually delete Facebook pixels, so if you already created one and didn't finish setting it up, you can actually just go to like open an events manager, and instead of actually giving you options down here, it will say, hey, do you want to finish setting it up? And you can click that button to start the setup process. But we're going to add a new one. So I'm just going to give it a name, Facebook Pixel 2020. You can do it for your website. This isn't essential. And I'll click continue. So here's the page you'll see. I used to do it through the WordPress plugin, but there's some benefits to doing it via the code on the website. It's a lot easier to add like multiple pixels, which you may need to do. And I actually found a way to make it a simple process. So yes, this does look pretty intimidating, but it's pretty simple. We want to leave this checked on, but we just click to copy the code. And it should say copy to clipboard. And we're actually going to use a plugin that lets us insert code into the header really easily. So you can use this for Google Analytics, you can use it to install all sorts of things. So it's very, very useful. What we want to do is make sure we're under plugins, add new, and we'll want to search head footer. This is one I've used, it works really, really well. What you want to do is click install now and then activate. And once you do that, you can go to settings, header and footer. So all you do is click paste and it'll paste the code we just copied. If you didn't copy it, you just click right here. That will copy it and just paste it right there. And then all you do is actually click save and boom, it'll be on your website. It'll be there. Once that's done, you can give it a minute or two and then actually send some test traffic to the page. So this page will load, and then it can take a second, it'll spin for a bit. Sometimes this takes a few minutes, but be patient. In a few seconds, it will pop up green. I actually already have a pixel set up on mine, but it should pop up green. And then you can do continue. Next thing you have to do is actually set up the events and custom conversions and get things 100% of the way ready to go.
So now you can go back to the website in Chrome and you can see if your pixel is showing up. It should show up green and show you that a pixel was found on your website. If this isn't showing up, you can wait 10 minutes, 20 minutes. It can take a second to show up. Now we're going to jump back into the Facebook pixel to actually set up all of the events and custom conversions so it's 100% ready to run ads.
There is a misconception, and that's that you need to set up these events or conversions or things like that in order to track the different page views and track where people are going or actually show it to people who visit specific pages. You actually can do all of that right out of the gate, and I'll show you. So if we open in analytics, you know, this is one I haven't set anything up. We actually can see exactly how many users, the user's activity, and if we scroll down, you can see, hey, here's how many people visit each URL, and you can also send ads just to people who, let's say, have visited this specific URL. Okay, so we don't need it for tracking. What are these actually for, and when should we use events versus custom conversions? So it already knows the pages that people are visiting, but we need to set it up so it's actually tracking, okay, when people hit this page or take this action, that means that they made a purchase. In this example, we'll say we're tracking purchases. Over time, it'll get really, really good at finding those purchases, people who hit that specific purchase page. And then we can actually later on create things like lookalikes of like, hey, find other people who are very, very similar to people who made purchases or made big purchases or frequent buyers or anything like that. So it's so key to have this set up correctly. Let me clear up some confusion on events versus custom conversions and when you should use each one. So whether you're setting up either, basically you're saying, okay, here's this action that I want people to take. And I want you to find people who are going to take this exact action and get better and better at finding similar people who are really, really likely to take this exact action. Okay, so let's say you sell granola bars. You may have different variations, different flavors, a 6-pack, a 20-pack, things like that. But you have that one core audience that's really interested in buying granola bars. It's a similar audience. So with a lot of people, you can just set up a purchase event for anyone who buys these, anyone who hits the thank you page, because then when it goes to find other people who also make purchases, it'll find people similar to the people who bought. So it's really, really good that that's just set up as a general purchase event. You know, the bigger that audience is, the better it is at optimizing things. But if you have very different products or things like that, let's say you add scuba gear or something like that, then when you're doing future ads, those audiences are very, very different. It can be a very different price point, very different product, very different audience. All of a sudden, it's going to get really confusing because it's going to try to optimize for purchases in the same way it did with granola bars. Or, you know, if you create a lookalike of, hey, create an audience similar to people who made a purchase, the granola bar people are going to be vastly different than the scuba diving people. So in this point, you can actually create a custom conversion, which is basically like, okay, here's an audience of just people who buy high-end scuba gear. Like, that's what we're tracking. So these things are separate so that the granola bar, it can just optimize for people who buy granola bars, and then you have the separate custom conversion over here that is tracking, you know, the people who want to buy scuba gear. And that way, both of them can optimize separately. So that's when you want to actually start to use custom conversions. So your audience could be entrepreneurs, but you have one $5 course aimed at people who are just starting off, and then a $1,000 course aimed at people who are really successful and have been in business for years and years. Well, those are very different products aimed at very different people, very different price points. So you'd probably want to make one like a purchase thing, but you'd want a custom conversion, let's say for the $1,000 course. So back to the granola bar example, even if I added some products, if they're a pretty similar audience, a pretty similar price point, like protein bars or granola you can take home, I would still just put those all under the purchase events. Those wouldn't be different enough that I'd want like a separate custom conversion. It would only be if something was for a very different audience or very different price point that I'd introduce those custom conversions. All right, now that we got that out of the way, let's actually set up. First, I'll show you how to set up events. So we go to that pixel. Pixel. We do open an events manager. So by default, it's probably going to try to set up some events like, hey, we think that this page means that someone made a purchase, but you always want to double check all of your thank you pages, all of your checkout pages to make sure that that's set up correctly, because otherwise it's not going to track your ad campaign properly, which is a huge, huge deal. So we want to go to settings, and you do want to make sure that the advanced matching is on. That's just really helpful. And we can go to event setup tool. You can also find that exact same thing by going to add events from the Pixel, launch event setup tool. And then you can actually go to each page individually and make sure the events are set up correctly. So let's go open website. So we can track by people clicking a button or by people hitting a specific URL, and then that meaning that they took a specific action. So I actually don't like tracking by button clicks. I'll show you how to do that, but then I'll talk about the big downsides. So like, here's this strategies to optimize and improve any ad campaign. People just punch in their name and email and they get instant access. So we can just click on that, and then when anyone clicks that button, we can say, hey, they become a lead. Awesome. If I click confirm, then this will be an event on this page on that button. But here's the problem. Let's say I punch in my info and I get one letter wrong on the email and click submit, or just tap it by mistake as I'm scrolling through or anything like that, it's going to register that as being a lead. Or let's say someone goes to make a purchase and they click the button, but then the page crashes and doesn't go through, or they enter one number of the credit card wrong. Well, because they're clicking this button, each time it could be registering it as a purchase. So I hear that a lot where people are like, hey, it's not tracking things correctly. And often it's because they're tracking a button click, which doesn't always line up. If things crash, if someone enters something wrong. So anytime you can track a URL, that is just so much better. So like, if someone punches in this info, it then can take them to a thank you page, especially like with purchases or checkouts or things like that. If you do track a URL, let's say this is a checkout page, you can just do track the URL. You can do initiate checkout. And then this is optional. You can say, hey, you know, for each person who, let's say, becomes a lead, I think the value of that is $3 for each person who initiates checkout. I think the value of that's like $4. You don't have to do that, but if I do this, it's then going to add that checkout event with this page saying, hey, when someone hits this page, that means that they are in checkout. Or if it's a thank you page, after someone's made a purchase, you can go to the purchase event. And like I said, it'll try to set them up automatically. If you include thank you in the URL, it can sometimes connect that with a purchase, but definitely go to every single purchase page and make sure that that purchase event is on that page, because that's essential for actually setting things up correctly. So I have this lead magnet on my website as well. So if I'm sending paid traffic, here's the page itself. And then rather than just tracking the button click, I'll show you how I'll set it up. I actually have a thank you page. So once they punch in their email, it takes them to this thank you page where they can download it. Well, anyone who hits this page is going to be a lead. It means they punched in their email, it went through, they entered it incorrectly, they didn't just click the button, they are actually a lead as well. So I will do track URL. And then I will do lead. If they just made a purchase, I do purchase and I click confirm and then finish setup. I'll link down to this resource below. If you're trying to get good results with Facebook ads, I think it's an essential checklist of just various strategies that I've used to run six-figure ad campaigns. It's easy to implement, but instantly helps you out. Okay, so now if we go back into that Pixel, you can see the lead event has been added. We'll want to send some test traffic. You know, it doesn't always work if you just go by yourself and do one page view. So we'll go to test events. And then we can paste that whole thing, open the website. So it took a number of minutes, but now it's actually turned from yellow to green. Sometimes you have to give it a little bit of time. And now we can actually go to the details of this event. You can see which page people are hitting when it's tracking the lead each time. At any point, you can actually go to manage events and you can see all URLs and all buttons that are associated with this event that it's tracking. So especially if you're sending traffic to any ad campaign, you want to make sure that the add to cart, lead, initiate checkout, and in particular purchases is set up correctly. It's at the right URL. That is so incredibly important. So 90% of you can just use the events to set everything up, but if you do have those unique audiences or products where you really want to optimize specifically for just that thing, let's jump into setting up custom conversions. Now, with the events, we just selected our pixel and made the events for it. Custom conversions, you can create it, just create them and then assign them to a specific pixel. All right, so I'm going to call this high ticket. And in this example, let's say I've got $7 courses, but now I want to launch a $1,000 course, which is going to be a very different customer, very different audience, very different thing to optimize for. So you can do a description if you want, but you want to make sure it's got the right pixel selected. Since for this one, we'll just be tracking a very specific URL, you can do all URL traffic, and then you're doing URL contains as part of the rule. So you can just do a part of that URL. I typically do it without the HTTPS or like a backslash. And you can enter a conversion value, that's not necessary. So you can do this for purchases, you can do it for collecting leads or things like that. So I'm going to click create. And it will show inactive at the start just because it hasn't got many people hitting that. You can refresh it, but sometimes you'll just have to wait for a little bit. Connect it with the pixel, but you also want to connect it with your ads manager. So what you want to do is you can just click share, and then under custom conversions, you have it here, but under connected assets, you can actually add your ad account. And now when you're in your ads manager, you can actually connect to that. Okay, so now let's say we're running ads. We've got everything connected. We've got the events on the right page. Sometimes you need to wait for a while for it to actually turn green or to get the right events. But now what we can do is we'll want to select conversions and click continue. And then it's like, okay, what do you want it to optimize for? What do you want to try to get people to do? Well, if we select the pixel, lead, that didn't used to be there. That's something we added as an event. And then high ticket is a custom conversion that we just did. So now it's going to track how many people actually hit that page. It's going to optimize for people getting to that thank you page for that high ticket product. Or, you know, if we do lead, every page that we have listed as a lead, every page that the event is set up as a lead, it's going to count as a lead and it's going to optimize for that. So it'll be looking at, okay, the people we showed it to who clicked on it, how many of them became a lead? How many made a purchase? How much was that purchase for? So it'll try to optimize for that. So for example, you could send them to a page with a product, but then they go to the home page and purchase something else. If you're just doing purchase, it would track that as an actual purchase because it's people who they showed the ad to who ended up in the purchase category. Whereas if it was, you know, a custom conversion, one specific product, then if you sent people to that product page, they ended up at the home page, they got something else, it wouldn't track that as that high ticket custom conversion, that specific thing. The next thing to do is run your ads. So you will want to punch in your email to get that checklist. And you'll also want to check out my video on advanced Facebook ad strategies. That's definitely a must watch if you want to get really good results.